excited about this.
Well, you know, this,
hyped out.
This takes me back to the high school days, and the first thing I thought of was my MIT tutor, who was a super nerd, and
oh
he's
my.
Like pounding that in my head. Okay, today
Not
is
that she's calling
a day,
you a nerd at all.
No. It's a good thing. It's a day that math lovers have been waiting for decades. It's extra special. Today's date, March 14th, 2015, coincides with the mathematical number pi of 3.14.
Yeah, this is a once-in-a-century occurrence. The next time it's going to happen is March 2115. So what exactly is pi, and how can we best celebrate this miracle occasion? Joining us now is Donna Dietz, a math and statistics professor at American University. Thank you so much for coming in.
Thank you for
You're
watching.
Just as excited.
Yeah.
Don't hold back. We've been waiting, as you said, decades
yes.
for this.
Yeah.
This is just an exciting day.
Yeah.
And some of you viewers might not remember what pi is, so I brought my handy little circle.
Yes, what is pi?
Okay.
Tell us.
So if you take a Tinker Toy circle or any other mm-hmm. circle, and you wrap a string around the outside, we call this the circumference.
Right.
And as long as we've known about circles, humans have said, well, now how many times can I stretch this circumference
right.
across? How many times can I stretch it across? And it's just about 3. And a little bit extra. And that has been annoying us for 4,000
oh,
years.
Oh, yeah. It's this big controversy.
Right. So, anyway, so we've learned a lot more about it in recent years, but it has been something historically. And if you express pi as a decimal, it's 3.14159265358973846227. And it
never stops, and it
repeats.
Right,
okay.
It's an irrational number.
It's
so
irrational.
Here's the deal. Do you have children? Is this your son here?
Yeah, that's Zach right there.
Do they all know? Do you pound this into their heads as well? Like, you know the...
No.
Because we never use it.
But in all seriousness, what's the significance? Why should we have to know about pi? You know, and you know, because a lot of people learn it in school and probably forgot all about
geometry
it. What's the significance of it?
It's a roundly loved irrational number. It's actually transcendental.
Okay.
In fact, if you know your polynomials from high school, like mm-hmm. x squared equals 2.
Oh, you're taking me back.
The answer is the square root of 2, right?
Yeah,
x squared
yeah.
equals 2's. But you can't even write a polynomial that pi will be a solution to it. It's that bad. It's even worse than irrational. It's transcendental, and that makes it so special. And e to the 2 pi I is actually 1.
Okay.
Yeah, and that's very special because you've got an imaginary number and a couple transcendental numbers mixing together to give us 1. That's right.
So how do we celebrate this historical or this once-in-a-century occurrence? How do we celebrate? What's the best way?
Well,
how will you celebrate?
Traditionally, people buy, pizzas and pies.
Right.
And
anything round.
And this is all just to, but there was a resolution passed that making Pi Day official in 2009 by the House of Representatives, and it's really to promote math and science education.
Yeah.
To just go rah, 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 and if you find a young person in your life, go out and say, hey, it's Pi Day, did you know?
Hey, it's Pi Day.
It is Pi Day. I'm so excited.
Young Mike here is very excited. Mike, do you ever use the...
I never have to use it, but I guess that's a good question for you. What are some ways that we use pi, in today's world that people just don't think about?
Yeah, exactly.
Because it's a little used number for folks like us.
Like a lot of things we learn in, math class, like geometry, trig, and things like that.
You forget them. My students remember it forever, though.
It's
well, with your enthusiasm,
learn,
why not? If I had a teacher like you teaching me this, I think I would have definitely remembered
it's
all
It's definitely
that.
Important to learn, obviously, but in real life, I mean, where would we use these types of things?
Yeah.
Crickets.
No.
Don't.
No.
The children, it is important to learn
yes,
them.
It is
part of geometry.
And
it expands your mind. It helps you comprehend
yes.
and think logically.
Yeah.
Well, Donna Dietz, you have been just so much fun. I think anyone who was wondering what in the world Pi Day, I think you've made it fun, just your enthusiasm. So thank you for that. All right. She's okay.
Now everybody's excited about Pi Day.
Right?
Oh.
And do we get to have Pi later? Is that is
We
that,
do.
See?
We're celebrating.
And the celebration continues.
Yes.
Are you going to stick around for that?
Sure.
All right.
Thank you, Donna.
We're back.